अपना प्रेसिडेंट डॉक्टर हारून दुरानी, अपना एग्जीक्यूटिव काउंसिल, ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स एंड अपना फैमिली एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज आवर स्ट्रेंज प्लेस टू बी। दिस इज द ओनली अमेरिकन पाकिस्तानी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आई हैव एवर बीन मेंबर ऑफ एंड आई एम अ लाइफ मेंबर एंड आई हैव अटेंडेड दिस वेरी रेगुलरली। अपना विजन इज एडवोकेसी, एडवोकेसी फॉर अपना डॉक्टर्स, एडवोकेसी फॉर दोस फिजिशियंस हु आर गोइंग टू पार्ट ऑफ द कमिंग ईयर्स एंड कमिंग डेकेड्स, एडवोकेसी फॉर सोशल जस्टिस, एडवोकेसी फॉर ह्यूमन राइट्स एंड एडवोकेसी फॉर सफरिंग ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। एडवोकेसी हैज इट्स ओन, एडवोकेसी हैज इट्स ओन पावर। And I'm going to give you a few examples of what I have been doing and why you should listen to me. About 15 years ago, I was working with Secretary Clinton, Hillary Clinton. She did not win the presidential election, but she became Secretary of State. Few weeks later, I was invited to State Department and I was asked, what is your interest? What do you want? People usually want positions. They want to be appointed. You know what I answered? There was a huge issue for Pakistani doctors to come to America after passing exams and after taking interviews and job offers, they could not get visa. I said, we need to resolve this issue now so that they can come, we can help them, but more importantly, they can be here and help American society. I am proud to say that within 3 years, 98% of APNA doctors, of Pakistani doctors, were not having problem with visa. In last 5 years, every single doctor who had a problem, I was able to resolve that with my advocacy. We all know how pandemic was. The world got affected by pandemic. Pakistan was one of the major sufferers in a way that Pakistan had a major population in the form of workforce in Middle East. Pakistan had about 60 to 70,000 people in Pakistan who came on vacation from Middle East, but they could not get back because they did not have access to vaccine. Pakistan had only access to Sinovac, which was only accepted in Pakistan or China. Pakistani authorities reached out to me. Workforce in Middle East is the backbone of economy of Pakistan. If you remember, I was the chair, national chair for Kamala Harris, national chair for Kamala Harris Asian Outreach. Kamala Harris happened to be vice president and handling this issue. I reached out to VP office and alhamdulillah, within 30 days, I was able to get 100,000 vaccine doses to Pakistan so all those people could go back to their world. After Afghan war, after the end of Afghan war, there was almost dead end between Pakistan and America. I was reached out, and this is also, I'm addressing to our ambassador. I was reached out by foreign minister. Please arrange some telephonic conversation between Pakistan, State Department, and Foreign Office. I said, why we should not do a little bit more? They said, no, at least we need to start something. Friends, with the advocacy, within 30 days, I was sitting in Islamabad with Chair Foreign Affairs Committee and Chair Asia Committee talking face to face. This is the bridge we can build. Pakistani diaspora, many NGOs, many organizations supported by our embassies have worked for 73 years on Kashmir issue and nothing could not be done. When India annexed Kashmir, and I want to clarify, India is our friend. I have a huge support from Indian Americans in California, but I respectfully disagree with the leadership. I was reached out by my Kashmiri friend from Srinagar, and I got involved in that. And you know what I was able to do with that advocacy? Not only tweets, not only statements, not only letters, I was able to convince Chair of India Caucus, Congressman Brad Sherman, to call a human rights abuse in Kashmir hearing in the Congress for who, because he was the Chair of Asia Committee. Nobody could believe Chair India Caucus will call abuses in Kashmir hearing in Congress. That hearing was the record heard hearing anywhere, and I'm proud to say this has been a research. We were able to save thousands of lives in Kashmir by stopping that aggression. I have a strong request for Ambassador Rashad. Please put Kashmir on the top agenda, because people are still suffering there every single day. Please bring it up on the podium. I want you to take our message further, and I decided to launch a campaign for running for office for Congress in District 40. People were skeptical. People were a little nervous. They said, what a Pakistani Muslim immigrant with an accent would do in District 40, which is 98% non-Muslim, 70% Caucasian, less than 1.5% South Asian. What place he has there? But they were not aware of my work. I sat on board of UNICEF.